In the last video, we looked at the Scan In Items page. That page is going to be important in this video as well, but first we're going to start somewhere different, the public-facing library catalog. Let's say it's late at night and I'm doing research at home and I just thought of a book that I need to get from the library. I'm not about to go out and get it now, but I also don't want to forget about it, so I'm going to go ahead and place a hold. Or maybe I want a title that's currently checked out, and while I'm not in any particular hurry to get it, I would like to make sure that I have first dibs as soon as it arrives back at the library. Or maybe I commute, or I'm a faculty member who lives off campus, and I'm not going to be able to get into the library anytime soon. Maybe it's a break, and the library only has limited opening hours. Or maybe I'm sick and staying home, so I would like to request a book and ask it to be mailed to me. Or maybe I just want a chapter scanned. In any of these situations, I would first need to locate the item in the library catalog. Once I've found it, I'll need to log in. Once logged in, I'll select the book and go to Get It. Under Get It, there is an option to request an item or request a chapter scan. I'm going to request this as an item. And if I need the item mailed, I'll add my address and send the request. I'm going to request this as a chapter scan. When requesting a chapter scan, I should say what part of the book I want scanned and check the copyright agreement and send the request. As patron, that's all I have to do to request an item for pickup. Now here's what it looks like at the circ desk. If I search for the item, I can see that it has a hold on it. I can even see who placed the hold, although this information should be kept private between you and the patron who placed the hold. If the item was checked out and I check it back in, it will notify me that there's a hold on it. At that point, I would go to Scan In Items, remember Scan In Items, and scan the barcode. Make sure that Place Directly on Hold Shelf is checked. If you've done it correctly, you'll notice Patron Physical Item Request is listed under the Request/Process type. The patron will get a notice informing them that the item is ready for pickup. If the hold was already in the stacks when the hold request was placed, it will show up in the Pick from Shelf list. We check this list twice a day to make sure that there are no holds needing pickup in our stacks. In Alma under Fulfillment, go to Pick from Shelf. On the side of the page is the Facets toolbar. Currently, that is closed for me, but I can open it by mousing over it and clicking the double arrows. Under the Facets toolbar, we see Request/Process type, with one patron physical item request and one patron digitization item request. There are other reasons why an item might show up in the Pick from Shelf list, so make sure that everything you're looking at is either a patron item request or a patron digitization request. Then we're going to print out all of the requested items by clicking on Print Slip Report and clicking Download. Download is going to send the item to Excel. Enable editing. The first thing I'm going to do is check whether there's an address listed. If there's an address, that means we're mailing it, so that's very important information to have. And in this case, there is an address, so we're going to need to keep that. We're also going to want to check for the edition, volume, or issue number. If someone requested just one book in a multi-volume set, some or all of these columns will have information in them. In this case, there's nothing here, so those can be deleted. For a digitization request, we also need the page numbers or chapter information. Finally, we need the title, the location, the call number, and the name of the patron who requested it. As you can see, there's a whole lot of other stuff on this spreadsheet, so we're going to get rid of most of it. Just select what we don't need and delete the entire column. Now we're going to print it out, and when printing it out, make sure that it all appears on one sheet. If it doesn't, you can change the page. You can change the paper orientation so that it fits. You can shrink it so that it fits. Find the items in the stacks. To digitize this item, use the scanner to scan what the patron wants and email the scans to them. Once the scans are emails, you can just delete the request. For whole item requests, we're going to go back again to that Scan In Items page under Fulfillment. Scan the item barcode and make sure that Place Directly on Hold Shelf is checked. The request process type is Patron Physical Item Request, and the patron gets a notice informing them that the item is ready for pickup.